Cheers. If you're watching for the first time, the business show airs every Thursday at 10 p.m. And for more business information, please visit the New Vision website. Now, for online advertisers, the effectiveness of this can only depend on the business owner that is arguing it out. Now, in this week's Make the Money segment, I speak to the director of Bear Libel Furniture.
Hassan Mkasa is my name. I'm the managing director of Bear Libel Furniture Enterprises. This is a furniture company doing local furniture, especially MDF. MDF is wood actually made here by one of the companies, one of the Indian companies, Nairo Ply, based in Nakasongola. That wood of MDF has made this work easy because it is already finished. Leave alone the other raw one you are making of whatever mahogany, musambia. It was taking a lot of time, but MDF it has already a coating that is finished. All we do is finishing the edges. So in that way, we don't waste customers' time. Customers can actually take their orders instantly. I can tell someone can give me a big order and I process it in just 2-3 days. And that has really picked the image of this business, because you know, in the past, the image of carpenters was really tarnished because they were delaying people's work, they were going away with their monies, you know, they were not fulfilling on their promises. Yeah, there are people who prefer that type of furniture, but now Chinese furniture has taken the market, and Chinese furniture was mainly MDF. It had taken the market, and they were not doing it different from the way we are doing it. And when we look at the market, ideally 90% are satisfied with this kind of MDF wood. Yeah, and I think if we can go with the 90%, that business is already enough. I realized we are doing good things. People would commit, they would come with the few products that we had. I realized we are doing good things. So I moved around because actually one of the problems that we have in furniture is organization. This is informal. We are in an informal sector. It is basically everyone for himself and God for us all. In furniture, someone just wakes up and sets up somewhere, and they see how they thrive through it. So I said, no, I'm not going to do this. I looked around for associations of furniture, but I wasn't getting any. So I moved around till a friend of mine told me, you can move to Zia, maybe they can help you. That is Uganda Small Scale Industries Association. So I moved to Zia, I inquired. They told me you are welcome. They told me about their modalities of membership and all that. I told them, I'm okay with it to be a member, because I want to be with you guys such that I can promote myself, such that my products can do what? Can move. So that was 2018. Then 2019, we were able to exhibit in that international trade fair in Uma, behind Uzia. They actually gave us space in their boardroom. That's where we exhibited. So when we exhibited there, we put our products there, and we got good comments. And that gave us the courage that at least we have a product. Now we need what? The market. So we come back. Some of the contacts we've got, people would come to our showrooms, they would buy, they would make them repairs, that kind of thing. So we got courage to move on. Then 2019, we were able to incorporate in the wooden furniture, mainly office and domestic furniture. Down the road, that was Feb. Then March, we went in a lockdown. And we had made some of the products in display. So we had to look back, and we had to think more how we could move on. We had done good PR, we had done good promotion, and we had to go online to promote our Facebook page, promoted it. We had to move. These days there are online business sites like Gigi, like Jumia. So we had to go to those ones and ask for their help. Good enough, they honored us, we were able to put our products there, and we've continued to actually do business even in COVID time. Yeah, people would order online, then we deliver, they pay us on delivery. We found a competitive advantage in that, because many carpenters, when they tell them you deliver, then I pay you, they have that fear that maybe I'm going to deliver and this guy is going to clone me. But for us, we are not about that, because we know we are confident of what we've made. We are confident of our quality. So there's no reason why I should get scared of someone telling me that deliver and I pay you on delivery. Sometimes confidence can be taken to be arrogance, but we are overconfident, I think, with our products. We are not confident with them, but we are over. I now am taking it to be accepted, and it gets accepted. But many players out there, they are just confident with their product. I say, I'm going to reach there and she will tell me, I say it was not this, I say it was the other color, I tell about this scratch, you know? So I think for us, we are just overconfident with our products. We know we are delivering it to be accepted. When the first lockdown, we were the first to be eased. Furniture sector, we were the first to be eased. From that time, then they would, because of the slowness in business, the other one I would order two, the other one orders five. That has also kept us going. Of course, you change according to the condition. You can't sit back and wait that because schools are closed, then you're so close. Because furniture is wide. If you are making this for school, you can now change to maybe dressing, maybe to domestic, because domestic furniture has actually the demand has slowed down, but it's not at zero. Because people have started homes. I have big hope for this business generally, not for a particular product, for this business generally. And so far as I've sold down, because so far as are expensive, someone has to part with 1.5, 2 million. And I think I've realized that as a problem. That's why they have sold down. We just have to keep something that can sustain the business till things normalize, because at least for us, we are still existing, but I've seen very many businesses have closed down. First of all, we should first appreciate for the little that we have. For whatever business, if your business is still standing still, then you first appreciate that, because I've seen people have lost money. Businesses have closed. They have closed. But if yours is still open and you can still pay rent, you can still pay your workers, because with this small business of ours, this is a workshop. It's not a factory. It's a workshop. It employs 5 people. 2 carpenters and sanders, 3 of them. But ever since we were eased in that lockdown, at least we do pay weekly. At least on average, each of them has been getting 50,000 a week in this lockdown period when there is no business. And I think that is, when I compare it to a teacher who has been there for 2 years earning nothing, I think it is really something. God has blessed us with this job, because even COVID, we were there, an order comes online, people come, display people come on. So it is really something different. It is something very, very far, because I think even the president realized, because when someone imports this TV stand, simple as it is, this is artisan work. It is not made by a complicated machine or wherever. We use handcrafts. When someone imports this, he has killed around, I've told you, this small workshop, this can benefit 5 of them. 5 of them. So if someone imports this, how many jobs has he killed? Very, 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 very many. And imagine this COVID, all of them can part with a minimum of 50,000 a week, weekly. And it has sustained them, they have families, and they are happy at least.
It won't guarantee you success just because you did not close shop and run for the hills when the COVID-19 pandemic struck. There are several things that you must do. And from Hassan, we've learned that use of social media, use of internet has helped him and has been his saving grace throughout the time that he has kept his shop open in the COVID-19 pandemic. Make sure you remain patient, focused, but also ensure to understand what's happening around you and know when to give up and when to stay focused into what you're doing for your business. We have shops open around town. I do believe that it's not because they have more money than the rest and not because they have got it better in the COVID-19 pandemic, but rather the resilience to continue, the focus to know what you're doing in your business, and also knowing that there are better times ahead that are coming will keep you together until we make it through the pandemic. So I do hope that you can learn a thing or two from this Make the Money segment. Always revisit, even on YouTube, to see how other people are managing without closing shop and going home because of the pandemic. Thank you so much for joining me for Make the Money segment. I'm Viola. See you next time. With the COVID-19 staying with us longer than expected, there is so much unanticipated spending, more than you've ever expected before. In the personal finance segment this week, we bring to you how to save and spend smart.
In personal finance tips this week, know how to save and spend smartly. Tip 1, start early. You need to start saving as early as possible in life. Even saving a small amount will not only build up a habit, but also give you a head start. The power of compounding will work in your favor over the long term, and you could witness an exponential growth in your savings. Do not doubt, start saving early, as you will need a small amount compared to a larger amount if you start late. Two, save and then spend. The general rule of savings is to spend what remains after you have saved out of your income. So, if you're spending fast and then saving what is left, you need to reverse the process. So, income minus savings should be the spending. I hope you got that right. Check balance accounts. Most of us have more than one bank account. Keep an eye on the bank statements to see if there are any charges deducted on account of different reasons. See if they can be reversed by the bank and take action to not let banks repeat them. Also, check for minimum balance charges and take action accordingly. 4. Cover risks. If you have financial dependents, buy adequate life insurance, preferably through a term insurance plan. Also, get health coverage for all family members. By paying a small cost as premium towards these risk covers, you ensure that your savings are not hit when emergency strikes and life goes and not derailed from the family. 5. The last one for this week is credit card dues. If you are in the habit of rolling out over your credit card dues each month, you are damaging your finances badly. The annual interest rate is close to 40% or even more in some cards. Further, if you do not repay in full, there is no interest-free period on your subsequent purchases. Make sure you pay the credit card outstanding amount in full by the due date in order to avoid late fees and other charges. And just, if you really care about this, then go digital, because as far as possible, make use of all the platforms for shopping, be it your home needs or utility payments, or even for buying life insurance. The premium of term insurance plans is generally lower by almost 25% than the offline version of the same plan. Once you build up a habit of saving on small transactions and on daily counts, the end result will be visible over time, and you will find newer ways to keep saving more even while spending. Both things can go hand in hand for saving a sizable amount over the long term.
It's always a pleasure having you on the Business Show. Before we go, let's take a look at the Forex and money market reports. That's it for this week's edition of The Business Show. Feel free to reach to us via the social media handles you see on your screen. COVID-19 is still with us. Please stay safe, clean up, and I'll see you next time.